hearts that take time to wait and prepare for your prompting and receiving what you have for us. And tonight, Lord, we wait and we wait expectantly for the gift of incredible love that was given to us. Our Savior was born tonight, the Messiah, long, long awaited. May our hearts be ready to receive what you have to offer in this beautiful, beautiful gift for us, Lord. So prepare our hearts for the days that we celebrate and we remember. But thank you that you are Emmanuel. You dwell with us not only today or tomorrow. You live within our hearts for those that welcome you and invite you into the messiness of our lives. You come in and you dwell there and you bless us richly. And so tonight, Father God, as we come to sing our praises and to welcome you and to say thank you for the incredible gift that you have given to us through Christ Jesus, our Redeemer, our Emmanuel, our Messiah. So thank you, and may this be your story, your biblical story, that you share tonight with us. In Christ's name, we pray. Amen.
Well, you're going to be seated for quite a while at the beginning of the service, so if you're feeling like, why are we standing a whole lot, you will, as Pastor Lindsay mentioned, you will have an opportunity to stand and to be able to groove a little bit. That'll happen toward the end. But we're going to let you stand for one, and feel free to just sing out with gusto, so please stand as we sing Angels from the Realms of Glory.
Light to live by. The light life blazed out of the darkness. The darkness couldn't put it out.
The life light was the real thing. Every person entering life, he brings into light. He was in the world. The world was there through him, and yet the world didn't even notice. He came to his own people, but they didn't want him. But whoever did want him, who believed he was who he claimed and would do what he said, he made to be their true selves, their child of God selves. These are the God begotten, not blood begotten, not flesh begotten, not sex begotten. The Word became flesh and blood and moved into the neighborhood. We saw the glory with our own eyes, the one of a kind glory, like Father, like Son, generous inside and out, true from start to finish.
Hear now the house of David. Is it a small thing for you to weary man? But will you weary my God also? Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel.
The birth of Jesus took place like this. His mother Mary was engaged to be married to Joseph. Before they came to the marriage bed, Joseph discovered she was pregnant. It was by the Holy Spirit, but he didn't know that. Joseph was chagrined, but noble, determined to take care of things quietly so Mary would not be disgraced.
While he was trying to figure a way out, he had a dream. God's angel spoke in the dream. Joseph, son of David, don't hesitate to get married. Mary's pregnancy is spirit conceived. God's Holy Spirit has made her pregnant. She will bring a son to birth, and when she does, you, Joseph, will name him Jesus. God saves, because he will save his people from their sins.
This would bring the prophet's embryonic sermon to full term. Watch for this. A virgin will get pregnant and bear a son. They will name him Emmanuel, Hebrew, for God is with us.
The moment had finally come. God was coming to dwell with his people. Generations of people had longed for and had prayed for and had hoped for and had believed that there would be a Messiah, that God would finally come. And as generation passed, he didn't come. But now the moment was here. The day they longed for had finally arrived.
Tree of Jesus Christ, David's son, Abraham's son. Abraham had Isaac, Isaac had Jacob, Jacob had Judah and his brothers. Judah had Perez and Zerah, the mother was Tamar. Perez had Hezron, Hezron had Aram, Aram had Abinadab, Abinadab had Nahshon, Nahshon had Salmon, Salmon had Boaz, his mother was Rahab. Boaz had Obed, Ruth was the mother. Obed had Jesse, Jesse had David, and David became king. David had Solomon, Uriah's wife was the mother. Solomon had Rehoboam, Rehoboam had Abijah, Abijah had Asa, Asa had Jehoshaphat, Jehoshaphat had Joram, Joram had Uzziah, Uzziah had Jotham. Jotham had Ahaz. Ahaz had Hezekiah. Hezekiah had Manasseh. Manasseh had Amon. Amon had Josiah. Josiah had Jehoiakim and his brothers. And then the people were taken into Babylonian exile. When the Babylonian exile ended, Jehoiakim and Shealtiel. Shealtiel had Zerubbabel. Zerubbabel had Abiud. Abiud had Eliakim, Eliakim had Azor, Azor had Zadok, Zadok had Achim. Achim had Eliad. Eliad had Eleazar. Eleazar had Matthew. Matthew had Jacob. Jacob had Joseph, Mary's husband. The Mary who gave birth to Jesus. The Jesus who was called Christ.
When Jesus entered public life, he was about 30 years old, the son, in public perception, of Joseph, who was son of Heli, son of Matthew, son of Levi, son of Melchi, son of Janai, son of Joseph, son of Matthias, son of Amos, son of Nahum, son of Elsie, son of Nagia, son of Maath, son of Matthias, son of Simeon, son of Josech, son of Joda, son of Jonan, son of Risa, son of Zerubbabel, son of Shealtiel, son of Neri, son of Melchi, son of Adai, son of Kosam, son of Amaldon, son of son of Joshua, son of Eleazar, son of Jonah, Joram, son of Matthew, son of Levi, son of Simeon, son of Judah, son of Joseph, son of Jonah, son of Eliakim, son of Mila, son of Manna, son of Mattatha, son of Nathan, son of David, son of Jesse, son of Obed, son of Boaz, son of Salmon, son of Nahshon, son of Amminadab, son of Admin, son of Arni, son of Hezron, son of Perez, son of Judah, son of Jacob, son of Isaac, son of Abraham, son of Terah, son of Nahor, son of Serug, son of Reu, son of Peleg, son of Eber, son of Shelah, son of Kenan, son of Arphaxad, son of Shem, son of Noah, son of Lamech, son of Methuselah, son of Enoch, son of Jared, son of Mahalalel, son of Kenan, son of Enosh, son of Seth, son of Adam, son of God.
Until the Son of God.
human ancestry, but also entirely God. We would think that God would have grand plans, great fanfare, all the religious leaders of the day there present to know and to see and to meet this little child. But that wasn't the case. Many people missed it.
About that time, Caesar Augustus ordered census to be taken throughout the empire. This was the first census when Quirinius was governor of Syria. Everyone had to travel to his own ancestral hometown to be counted for. So Joseph went from the Galilean town of Nazareth up to Bethlehem in Judah, David's town, for the census. As a descendant of David, he had to go there. He went with Mary, his fiancée, who was pregnant. While they were there, the time came for her to give birth. She gave birth to a son, her firstborn. She wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger because there was no room in the hospital.
They had set night watches over their sheep. Suddenly, God's angel stood among them, and God's glory blazed around them. They were terrified. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I'm here to announce a great and joyful event that is meant for everybody, worldwide. A Savior has just been born in David's town. A Savior who is Messiah and Master. This is what you're to look for. A baby wrapped in a blanket and lying in a manger." At once, the angel was joined by a huge angelic choir singing God's praises. Glory to God in the heavenly heights. Peace to all men and women on earth who please Him. As the angel choir withdrew into heaven, the sheepherders talked it over. "Let's go over to Bethlehem as fast as we can and see for ourselves what God has revealed to us." They left, running, and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. Seeing was believing. They told everyone they met what the angels had said about this child. All who heard the sheepherders were impressed. Mary kept all these things to herself, holding them dear, deep within herself. The sheepherders returned and let loose, glorifying and praising God for everything they had heard about and seen. It turned out exactly the way they had been told.
Something extraordinary happened that night. Announced by angels to some of society's lowliest people. Many missed it, but they caught it. The message still has implications today. It wasn't just a message for a couple of thousand or people a couple of thousand years ago. It's an amazing message of hope and peace and love and salvation. It's a message where we each have to come face to face with the one who at one time was in a manger and who's now grown up, has died and been resurrected. And He's here present with us, although we can't see Him this evening. We can certainly sense Him and know that He is alive. Have you come this evening to meet with Jesus? As you sing this next song, I encourage you to join in with the angels in Excelsis Deo. It actually means glory to God in the highest. So stand and let's sing together.
Oh,
faithful, and as I mentioned before, it's 100% God, 100% human being. And one of these verses is a little bit strange. It talks about God of God, light of light, and it's a bit of a theological statement, but sing along with us. Gord will lead us to that one, so let's continue to sing. God doesn't kind of force his way into our hearts. He presents himself as a vulnerable one and then invites us and says, will you come? Will you see me? Will you believe in me? Will you trust me? Will you make me your Savior? Today that opportunity exists for each of us. Many of us have received him. We've accepted him. We are now walking with him. But many of us have turned our backs on him. We've ignored him. We've gone our own way. And so peace has come. We talk about him as the Prince of Peace. Peace has come to those in whose hearts he dwells. But for those who have not received him, there is no peace. And in the world, there still is no peace apart from the peace that comes through those who have received him into their lives, into their hearts. There's a book that was written not too long ago. It's called Mistakes Were Made, and then in brackets, but not by me. And see, that's the problem with sin, right? We like to, you know, there's a lot of problems out there. I didn't do it. It's not me. I'm not the problem. And that's the very place that if we want to receive Christ, if we want to come once again, we actually have to take a different posture. We have to say, mistakes have been made, sin has been committed, and I am the culprit. It's me, and it begins with me. Not too long ago, I was sitting in a meeting, and I found myself thinking, it smells like smelly feet. Somebody's got stinky feet, like bad shoes, or like running shoes, or something like that. You know that smell. Oh, it's so terrible. And, you know, you kind of bend down, you get a little bit of a whiff. Ooh, your feet are stink so bad. And then I found who it was.
No, Mom.
Me. It was me. I was the one with the stinky feet. You know, it's great to know that Jesus came into the stinkiest of places. That he was not born in a great kingdom. He was not born in a meticulous hospital. He was born in a smelly, stinky stable, in a manger. And Jesus says, you know what, if you stink, you come. You're going to fit in with me and all the people around me that I've gathered. Because they all recognize, they all know they stink. They all know they have smelly feet. These are the people that have said, yeah, mistakes were made, and it's by me. And I need a Savior. And his name's Jesus. And I want to encourage you, as you hear these scriptures, reflect on what's being said about you and about sin and about what Jesus has done.
But when the time arrived that was set by God the Father, God sent his Son, born among us of a woman, born under the conditions of the law, so that he might redeem those of us who have been kidnapped by the law. Thus, we have been set free to experience our rightful heritage. You can tell for sure that you are now fully adopted as his own children, because God sent the Spirit of his Son into our lives, crying out, Papa, Father. Doesn't that privilege of intimate conversation with God make it plain that you're not a slave, but a child? And if you are a child, you're also an heir with complete access to the inheritance. As long as you did what you felt like doing, ignoring God, you didn't have to bother with right thinking, or right living, or right anything for that matter. But do you call that a free life? What did you get out of it? Nothing you're proud of. Where did it get you? A dead end. But now that you've found you don't have to listen to sin tell you what to do, and have discovered the delight of listening to God telling you, what a surprise, a whole, healed, put together life right now, with more and more life on the way. Work hard for sin your whole life, and your pension is death. But God's gift is real life, eternal life, delivered by Jesus, our Master.
God offers you life today. In the present, it's announced today, a Savior has been born, and he wants you to meet him. He's calling you to come. Come and see what God has done, the light of the world given for us.
Incarnate of divine, star and angels gave the sign. No!
Song, I encourage you to stand when you feel ready to say, yeah, Jesus, I want to trust you. I want to be there. I want to see you in all of your fullness, and I want to receive you. And may that be your act of worship. May that be your opening your heart to the Lord Jesus Christ. So this next song is called A Christmas Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Christ the Savior of the world, He has come. Alleluia. Alleluia. To the highest name of all. Alleluia. The heavens roar, the angels sing, all glory to our God and King. O night divine, forevermore, alleluia. The heavens roar, the angels sing, all glory to our God and King. O night divine, forevermore.
Burning will be fuel for the fire.
Received Christ by faith into our hearts, we wait for conflict and war to be finished. Not on the inside, he's already done that work, but all around us in the world, we're awaiting him, our coming king, once again.
But you, Bethlehem, David's country, the runt of the litter, from you will come the leader, who will shepherd rule Israel. He'll be no upstart, no pretender. His family tree is ancient and distinguished. Meanwhile, Israel will be in foster homes until the birth pangs are over and the child is born. And the scattered brothers come back home to the family of Israel. He will stand tall in his shepherd rule by God's strength, centered in the majesty of God revealed, and the people will have a good and safe home, for the whole world will hold him in respect. Peacemaker of the world.
You're ready to stand. We're on the home stretch now, so this is the last. You're not going to sit, actually. You're just going to stand from here on out. So why don't you stand and sing this one there?
Okay, so this song has some directions for you. In that pause, it's 8 weeks. It feels a little weird at first. It's going to take some time to get used to.
Yeah.
I invite you to stand. Spirit is very easy.
In the leafy winter, all creation groans for a world in darkness, frozen like a stone. Light is breaking in a stable.
Each morning, he'll put on sturdy work clothes and boots and build righteousness and faithfulness in the land.
The wolf will romp with the lamb, The leopard will sleep with the kid.
Calf and lion will eat from the same trough, and a little child will tend them.
Cow and bear will graze the same pasture. Their calves and cubs grow up together, and the lion eats straw like the ox.
The nursing child will crawl over rattlesnake dens. The toddler will stick his hand down the hole of a serpent.
Neither animal nor human will hurt or kill on my holy mountain.
The whole earth will be brimming with knowing God alive, a living knowledge of God, ocean deep and ocean wide.
So you can see the clock. You know what time it is. So if you need to get going and those sorts of things, that's okay. There's only a few more songs, but we are escalating, right? The songs get more and more fun as we move to the conclusion. So if you need to go, that's okay. But if you want to have some fun, and this is where you maybe want a little bit more room around you. So sing with us. This is it. We have a Savior. He's born. Let's sing along.
Thank you.
Raise your voice. Make it good and loud, Jerusalem. You are the preacher of good news. Speak loud and clear. Don't be timid. Tell the cities of Judah, look, your God. Look at him. God, the master, comes in power, ready to go into action. He is going to pay back his enemies and reward those who have loved him. Like a shepherd, he will care for his flock, gathering the lambs in his arms, hugging them as he carries them, leading the nursing ewes to good pasture.
So we can all sing, this is my story, and this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. We're finishing this one, so let's sing this out.
Purchase our glory.
Well, thank you for such a beautiful bit of songs and stories. And what a great night this has been together. Tomorrow we have a service at 10 o'clock, and one again on January 1st. We'd love to see you all there. We understand that it's a time for family as well, so if you can't make it, that's great too. But it'll be a great service tomorrow to continue the singing and the worship together. And we have the skate on December 31st at 6:30, but we'd love to see you there. It's a huge congregational event, so invite all your friends, family, neighbors. It's really no limit. 6:30 P&A Center, that'd be really great. Let's just pray. Jesus, we thank you for your story. We thank you for your song. And thank you that we can be invited into that, and that we can sing, and that we can gather together and be a part of that story. May we be your light to the world in dark places, and may we share that light with those around us. We thank you for your love and for your peace that you've brought. In your name, amen. Go in peace and Merry Christmas. Give a hug before you leave.